warning. I'm Junjun Fedizana, of Futuristic Aviation and Maritime Enterprise, or FAME. We are currently working on community-focused technology solutions to help fight COVID-19. Let me share to you how my team and I made use of our technology to create devices to help fight COVID-19 in our country. We create transponders that transmit telemetry data using the LoRaWAN network for aircrafts, boats, and even sensitive sensor data. Before the pandemic, our daily routine was to install transponders to fishing vessels to be used for tracking and monitoring. The technology quickly evolved and is now also being used for fish catch documentation and traceability. So we would know exactly where our fishes are caught and when it was caught. But on March 12, 2020, while we are in Lagonoy Gulf, in Bicol, installing transponders, the news broke out. We are going to be on lockdown. Immediately, all of us took our flights back to Manila and Jensen and followed the protocols set by government. But while working from home, we had several questions in mind. How can we use our platform to help fight COVID-19? As engineers, what types of hardware can we make? What are the major issues where we can really help? In a matter of weeks, our first COVID-19 project is running. Together with DOST, we designed a smart specimen collection booth equipped with our sensors so it can be used by our country for testing. In just 1 month, we were able to deliver 132 specimen collection booths to different hospitals around the Philippines with the help of the Office of Civil Defense, Philippine Air Force, and Philippine Coast Guard. We opened up our design so that others can replicate, and we are proud to say that it is also being used in Ethiopia, in Africa, right now. Fortunately, we did not stop there. Another project that we are working on is called Ruah. In Hebrew, it means breath of God. It's an automatic respiratory support actuator made of available parts, including our own transponder parts. The device can be used to help patients breathe while waiting for a ventilator to be available. With the help of medical experts and other experts from different universities, we formed a discussion group to be able to help us develop further. We are now on our third prototype, complete with a remote interface to avoid frontliners having physical contact with patients. Another challenge came. There's a problem. Last June 25, the World Health Organization just announced that there is already a shortage of oxygen equipment around the world. We now know that COVID-19 patients die and their organs fail because of the lack of oxygen in the body. The world needs more oxygen equipment more than ever. That's why we developed Ruah O2, Automatic Oxygen Concentrator. It's a portable and modular device that can compress and concentrate the amount of oxygen in the air and deliver it to the patient continuously. Let me show you how it works. It's a four-step process. We get air using a pump. We filter the air using various filters, including HEPA filters. And we separate the harmful gases using molecular sieves. This removes most of the nitrogen in the air mixture. The air with concentrated oxygen is compressed, and if connected to the patient, will readily deliver the air with concentrated oxygen for breathing. We are even creating a mobile app that can be used to monitor the device remotely. The video on the right shows how it runs. It can be delivered to the patient directly for those that can still breathe on their own, or it can be connected to a ventilator or actuator to support the patient's breathing. As a result of our works, we recently won the Kubo Rescue COVID-19 competition. And we also got a grant from PhilDev and UNDP worth $10,000. This will help further finance our Ruah O2 development. We are currently collaborating with Animal Labs of La Salle to get help not only on business models, but also on medical and engineering expertise. We believe that if we can bring Ruah and Ruah O2 to hospitals, health centers, quarantine facilities, or even on homes of those that are vulnerable, we can really help save lives not only in the country, but in the entire world. We need more collaborators and manufacturing partners who can help us in our development. Help us in making this dream a reality. Thank you.